Okay. So that brings IT. Us to our favorite IT industry.
Yeah.
Yeah. So again, just I have tried to slightly different color I want to give on IT industry.
Okay.
IT industry represents 7-odd% of India's GDP.
GDP. Phenomenal. Yeah.
Which is almost equal to auto sector.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Auto is about 15% of India's manufacturing and
yeah.
half of that is auto.
Yeah.
So about 7.5-8% is auto, I think.
Maximum.
So this is
So
you know, I mean, it's such a huge industry. You don't realize
because yeah.
you see cars, so you think, okay, China is getting rid of India dollars. You see, but this you don't see. It's
here. Yeah.
But it actually is equal to 7-8%
Right.
So and it's been steadily increasing.
Steadily increasing.
From 0.4% of GDP to about 7% of GDP. So very, very significant industry. This chart we already seen. It says basically that driver growth is going to be cost arbitrage.
Cost arbitrage.
But besides this cost arbitrage, the fact that we are cost competitive, there is a new vector that basically India is trying to position itself, which is saying value.
Okay.
Right? We are a value provider.
Okay.
And today the measure of value is this business called digital.
Okay.
How good are you in digital?
Okay.
So, and the reason for that is that the expectation is that over the next 4 or 5 years or even next 10 years, traditional IT, you can see, is actually going to decline.
Okay.
And digital is going to increase.
Okay.
And if you break down the digital, it is like this. You know, cloud share, cloud migration.
Yeah.
Digital transfer, digital, implementing digital strategies for companies.
Yeah.
And, you know, doing blockchain, robotics, data centers. And
right.
So, so data center is not growing, but these are all growing, okay?
Fantastic.
And so you can see that this is CAGR of 35 to 45, CAGR of 15 to 20 and so on.
Yeah.
So this segment, which is digital, is where India has a potential to increase its value.
Yeah.
Be on the high value.
Right.
Right. We have been doing, because of cost, we have been getting a lot of business.
Yeah.
But how can we do much higher premium businesses?
Yeah.
By using digital as the lever.
Okay.
That's the question. And the reason why analysts think that India is going to be a great place for digital is because if you look at the digitally trained employees, like the students will come out from our program.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They'll have knowledge of data science.
Yes.
70 to 75% of these skills are going to come from India.
Fantastic.
Okay. Okay. 5% will come from Latin America.
Yeah.
Somewhere may
pack Asia and, Pacific and
So we are going to be the biggest pool of digitally trained resources in the world.
Okay.
That's
a very
nobody
positive
else
thing.
Can. Yeah, yeah. It's very positive thing.
Yeah.
And also there is expectation that outsourcing, outsourcing basically means that instead of doing in-house, you do it with a third-party contractor.
Yeah.
It's already quite high. So if you see, for example, the outsourcing percentage has been around 60%. So 60% of IT work in companies, Fortune 500 companies, is done by external people. And that is expected to go to even 70%. So outsourcing is going to increase. And we saw the billing rate advantages for India.
Yeah.
Offshoring, which means sending it to India,
will
also increase. So these two vectors together, outsourcing and offshoring, means that India can expect to see a fairly large volume of work coming our way. In addition to the fact that they are going to also move up the value curve because we are doing digital.
Digital.
So these are the vectors.
Okay.
Okay. So, I think this is a chart which Pankaj Jolote and somebody else wrote in CACM.
Okay.
I thought it's an interesting chart.
Yeah.
How the revenues has grown.
Yeah.
This is the number of global innovation centers. GIC is global innovation center.
Okay.
Companies, for multinational companies who set up operations in India to do R&D work, IT work.
Okay.
Or R&D work or support work.
Yeah.
Right? BPO work, which is also considered part of IT.
KPO?
Knowledge. BPO is knowledge processing outsourcing, all part of BPO, business process outsourcing.
Yeah.
So BPO has many segments.
Yeah.
So call center being the lowest value and KPO being at a
higher level. Yeah.
So GIs, so global innovation centers basically are the foreign companies, Indian centers to do R&D or IT work.
Okay.
And this work basically, you can see the number of centers that have come up in the last, from 2000, it was only 285, it has gone to 1,020. So very large number of people have come to India and set up centers. And
tech
you can see the tech startups
also. Yeah.
So these three pictures, composite pictures tell you.
Yeah.
You know, the three ways in which IT is contributing.
Okay.
You can see also that the market share, worldwide market share for TCS is, you know,
by
2024, it's going to become 3.9%.
Okay.
We saw that, you know, one of the earlier charts I showed you, 1.6%.
Yeah.
but that is old,
yeah.
right?
Yeah,
so 2019, it's already 2.1%
yeah, expected.
Now it's going to 3.9%.
Okay.
It's going to increase.
Yeah.
So also Infosys, also TCS. In fact, actually, this Wipro chart is also, I don't think it's correct.
Okay.
It'll also show increase.
Increase, in, yeah.
With a new CEO now and all.
Yeah.
So they're all showing increases.
Okay.
Because we are taking away work in some sense from the established players in the West.
Yes.
Because of our cost competitiveness.
Cost advantages. And
ability to mobilize, you know,
digitally trained workers.
Digitally trained workers.
Yeah.
And therefore, double-digit revenue growth is possible.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that's basically our analysis of our IT industry.
Okay.
We don't look too much at cost. Of course, we can look at cost, but these are companies operating at 20% profit and high ROC and hardly any cost. Employee cost is only cost.
Yes.
So there is nothing much to look at it from those levers. You have to look at growth basically.
Right.
In this.
Right.
So the growth is going to come by more outsourcing, more offshoring, and more digital.
Yeah.
These are the big growth factors.
And the conventional kind of, you know, segregation of costs like in manufacturing is not applicable to services industry.
Yeah.
So that does not
make much of a correct.
So that's very, very useful analysis, because now we have firm level analysis, then we have an industry level analysis.
Yeah.
So we have a kind of a comprehensive picture of how, you know, data is used in terms of assessing firm performance as well as industry performance.
And how can you present it?
That's a key thing that we really
present it nicely with charts.
Yeah.
With the right kind of charts.
Yeah. And that's a main point that, again, we want to emphasize in this two sessions.
So you want to tell a story. I mean, if you don't tell the story well.
Yeah. Data is there everywhere.
Data is
but you have to pick the data and present it correctly.
Present it in the form of a storyline.
Yes.
Something. What is going on? What is
the
underlying insight?
Yes.
What insight do we have by looking at this data? And how does that insight help us to make informed decisions?
Right.
Where to invest, what to do, whether to use your cash, how to use your cash, whether to retire debt, what to do, right?
Yeah. And in terms of getting that story in line is where our discussions in terms of our conceptual concepts of cost, production, everything helps us
correct.
In that.
Correct. Yeah. Correct.